this Gimp workshop tutorial, we are going to create a metal Crome statue. Go to File, and in the drop-down menu we click on Open. Here we can search for the image that we want to use and open it. If you want to follow along, there is a download link for the image of the bodybuilder, an example image, and the PDF text file in the video description. Our image of the bodybuilder has a transparent background. Back to the menu bar, and now we click on View, go to Zoom, and in the flyout menu we click on Fit Image in Window. Click on the New Layer button at the bottom of the Layers panel. We can name this layer Background White. The mode should be normal, and we choose as Fill Width the background color. This should be white by default. Click OK. Click on the downwards pointing arrow to place it below the 0-1 layer. And again a new layer. Rename this one Background Black. Now we choose as the fill width the foreground color, which should be black. Then click OK. Then we can press the upwards pointing arrow on our keyboard to make the 0-2 top layer active. Or we can just click on the thumbnail. Go to Colors and Brightness and Contrast. Make the brightness about 40 and the contrast about 30. Click the preview off and on to see the difference, and then click OK. Back to the menu bar, and now we click on Filters. Here we go to Blur, and then we click on Selective Gaussian Blur. Make the blur radius 50. Gimp needs quite some time to apply this effect, and it's also not very good visible while it's doing so. Because of that, we click OK. Now we can see in the circle how long it takes and how far Gimp is. It's best just to wait to avoid crashing of Gimp or of your system. Selective Gaussian Blur does not act on all pixels. Blur is applied only if the difference between its value and the value of the surrounding pixels is less than the defined delta value. In this way, the contrasts are preserved because difference is high on contrast limits. When the effect is applied, we can see that the skin is fairly smooth, but we still have our contrast. Now we can continue by going to Colors and Curves. I've made a preset for this image, so I will open this. You can copy these settings and of course adjust them by clicking and dragging the points to your liking. Or you can add new points. Then click OK. While this looks good already, we can however go a bit further. The effect on the left arm is a bit less than the rest, so we can work on that some more. Go to the toolbox and make the Free Select tool active. Click on the second mode, which is Add to Current Selection. We can now make multiple selections. Select the area of the left arm that you want to edit, roughly, like so. Click the last node over the first one. Then double-click inside the selection to apply it. And because the elbow of the right arm is a bit fake, we can select this area too. Now go to Select and click on Feather. Feather the selection with 100 pixels to blur the edge of the selection. Click OK. Now we can open the Curves dialog box again by going to Colors and Curves once more. Here we can apply the same settings as we did the first time and adjust them to our liking. When we feel it looks good, we click OK. Go to Select and click on None to deselect the selection. I think the effect looks good now as it is, but we can, depending on the image that we use, also repeat the curves. Or we can adjust the brightness and contrast. It all depends on the image that we use and on what we think looks best. click on the eye of the black background layer to turn it off and on. In that way, we can see how our work looks on a white background. And that's how we can turn a bodybuilder into a metal chrome statue. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please take a moment to like and comment. Thank you very much for watching.